I'm Argenta Price. I'm a graduate student in Christine Guthrie's lab at UCSF. Our lab works on the spliceosome, which is a very interesting molecular machine. It's not directly related to any disease. We're studying something that's much more basic than that, but errors in splicing lead to a whole lot of different types of disease. So it can be mutated in cancers, it can be mutated in different heart diseases, and there's a particular type of blindness called retinitis pigmentosa that some people in the lab are more directly studying because they're studying mutations that specifically affect that. And so there are a lot of diseases that it impacts, but we're not studying a specific type of disease. I've always been interested in science. I remember when I was maybe six thinking, what do people do if they're not scientists? Like, there are no other jobs. I think because my dad's a geologist, my mom was a chemist and then switched to being a teacher, but, you know, always focusing on science in her teaching. And so I grew up with my role models were scientists. So I grew up in Reno, Nevada. I went to public school there, and then I went to college at Yale, and I majored in molecular cellular developmental biology there. Our lab is three bays of benches with desks and benches, and so I'm kind of in the middle of that. And so I have a desk and a bench, and I spend some of my time at a computer, sometimes just sending emails, but other times analyzing data. And I also work at my bench. Then there's also the biochemical sides of things. I do a lot of pouring gels and running gels for the splicing assays. And I've done some work in the cold room, which is not fun because it's 4 degrees. Some of the biochemistry work needs to be done in the cold so that all of the proteins you're making stay happy. And so spend a fair bit of time in there. And then I also spend some time in the hot room, which is for radioactivity. It's definitely nice to be able to be up and moving and doing physical things. The project that I'm working on right now is actually one that is pretty collaborative in our lab. Right now it's my main project, but two or three other people in the lab have it as sort of a side project. So it's kind of fun to be able to come in, and we're just always talking about, oh, well, what does this mean? And there's always somebody to talk to. So that's a really exciting part of it. You know, we're learning something new. This isn't something that people know the answers to yet. And So some advice I would have for someone who's considering biomedical research would be to find a problem that you really enjoy working on, because if you don't have the excitement about the question and the project, then you're going to have troubles with the ups and downs of experiments not working. And so you really need to have a problem that you're really interested in, and if that's basic biochemistry or something that's very disease related, great. But just find a problem that you're really interested in.